Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the second lesson about conditional statements. In this lesson, I will tell you about the types of conditional statements and we will also practice some examples of conditional statements. So let's begin. In the first type of if statements, we have only one if statement with one or many conditions inside the if, and it will depend upon those conditions enclosed in the if. If all of those conditions are true, then the expressions will be executed. If any of those conditions is false, then the whole condition will be considered as false. So there will be no output. So for this condition, if this conditions or all the conditions are true, then it will execute the expressions. Otherwise, there will be no output. In the second type of conditional statements, we have two independent if statements which execute their expressions independent of one another. So if this condition is true as well as this condition is true, then both the expressions will be executed. If the first condition is true and the second condition is false, then only the first expression will be executed. If first condition is false and second condition is true, then only these expressions will be executed. However, if both the conditions are false, then there will be no output. In the third type of conditional statements, which is also called as if-else statements, in these statements, if the condition here given here is true, then these expressions will be executed. In case this condition is false, then the expressions after the else statement would be executed. Fourth type of conditional statements are called if-else-if statements, in which we can give multiple if statements. The later if conditions are dependent on the previous conditions. So if this condition is true, then this condition will be evaluated. However, if this condition is false, this will not be evaluated and there will be no output. If this condition is true, then expressions 1 will be executed. If this condition is false, then the second condition will be evaluated. And if this condition is true, then expression 2 will be executed. And in case this condition is also false, then it will lead to the else statement where the expression 3 will be executed. Another type of if conditions are called nested if. In the nested if, one if condition is enclosed in another if condition. In this case, if condition 1 is true and condition 2 is false, then only expression 1 will be executed. In case both the conditions are true, then expression 1 and expression 2 both will be executed. If first condition is false, then this condition will not be evaluated, whether it is true or false. So in case this is false, and no expression will be executed. The second type of nested if conditional statements are those in which the first if doesn't have any expressions. Here you can see that the first if condition has expressions, while here in this case, the first if condition doesn't have any expressions, while the second if is nested in the first condition. So we have only expressions inside the second if condition. So these expressions will depend on both the conditions. If both the conditions are true, these expressions will be executed. If this is false, then these expressions will not be executed. If this is true and this is false, again these expressions will not be executed. And the last type of if else condition is a single command if else, in which we give a condition here. If this condition is true, then the expressions given here in the yes place will be executed. And in case this condition is false, then those expressions that are given in the place of no, they will be executed. So if the condition is true, that is the test is true, the yes expressions will be executed. And in case the condition is false, then the no expressions will be executed. Okay, you will be thinking about what type of conditions can we give inside the if statements. So conditions are called those expressions whose answers could be either true or false. Those conditions can be included as conditions inside the if statement. However, if the answer is other than true and false, you cannot give those as conditions inside if statements. For example, A is greater than B. The answer of this statement could either be true or false. Similarly, A is greater than or equal to B. Again, its answer could be true or false. Here, A is greater than, A is smaller than B, A is smaller than equal to B, A is equal to B. Remember, in R, you cannot use single is equal to for testing the equality of two numbers or two statements. You will have to use 2 is equal to. For example, the value of A is 5 and the value of B is 5. So A is equal to B will give you true. If value of A is 5 and value of B is 6, then this statement will give a false output. Similarly, A percent in percent B. This percent in percent B is used to test whether A is the subset of B or not. Or you can also say that A is the member of B or not. So the answer of this statement could also be true or false. If A is the member of B, then the answer of this statement will be true. And if A is not the member of B, then the answer of this statement will be false. Another statements that we can give as conditions inside if are any and all statements. Here, this any is used for situations where we want to test if either of these conditions is true or not. So if you want to test whether any condition of these three conditions is true or not, if any one of these is true, then the answer of this statement would be true. If none of these conditions is true, the answer will be false. In this case, if all the conditions are true, then the output will be true. And if any of these conditions is false, then the output would be false. For example, if this is true, and this one is false, the output will also be false. And if this is true, this one is true, and this third condition is also true, then the output will be true. However, in this case, if only this condition is true and this and these two conditions are false, still their output will be true. First, let's try the first one, the simple if statement. First of all, open an empty R script so that we can write our script here. So the first type of if statements are, for that to test, we will first define some variables. For example, A is equal to 7 and B is equal to 3, suppose. Now we will test different types of conditions here with if statements. If A is equal to B, the output of this will be either true or false. As we know that A is not equal to B, that's why the output of this is false. So it will not give any output print. You can type any statement here. For example, I can type that yes, A is equal to B. Let's now select all of these lines and then holding control, press enter. You can see that it only ran the script, but it didn't give any answer here. Now let's type here not equal to. The sign for not is equal to is like this. A is not equal to B. So you'll have to change here. A is not equal to B. Now let's select this, control enter. The output is here. A is not equal to B. Because your A is not equal to B, the condition is true. That's why it will print anything you write here. Even if you write A is equal to B, it will give you the output of A is equal to B. Even if A is not equal to B, still it will give you the output of that. A is equal to B. So be careful when typing such statements here, because it will give you the output whatever you type here. Multiple if conditions. If A is greater than B, print A is greater. As you can see that A is greater, that's why it will print both the output, that is A is equal to B and A is greater. Now let's try if and else statements. Remove this and type else here and then print A is equal to B and type here A is not equal to B. Now let's try and run. A is not equal to B. As you can see that this condition is true, that's why it will print this statement but not this one. Now let's make this condition false. Now this statement will be executed. A is equal to B. It doesn't see what is written here. It only checks if this condition is true or false. If this is true, it will print whatever written here. And if this condition is false, then it will print this statement whatever it is. As you can see, the statement is actually wrong. A is equal to B, because we can see that A is not equal to B. But as we have given this statement, the else statement, that's why it will print it. Let's include another if, else if A is greater than B, then print this and else print something else. Let's print wow. Okay. Now we are checking whether A is equal to B. This condition is true, then this statement will be executed. If this is false, then this condition will be evaluated. If this is true, this statement will be executed. And if this is false, then the result will be this. So now let's try. Let's run this code. A is equal to B. It executed this statement because this condition is true. This condition is false. This is true. That's why it gave you output like this. Now let's make this false. Now this is also false and this is also false. So it will give you the output of wow. Yes, the wow output will be printed on the screen. Now let's check this type of if statements. If A is greater than B, then print Roshan. This is nested if, so another if inside if. If A is not equal to B, then print Ocean. Okay, now first it will evaluate this condition. If this is true, it will print this, and then this condition will be evaluated. If this is also true, then it will print this as well. If this one is false, then none of these statements will be executed, whether this is true or not. It will not be evaluated. So now let's select this. As you can see, both the statements have been executed and Roshan and Potion both are printed out on the screen because both the conditions are true. Now let's make this condition false. As you can see, this condition is true, but it will first evaluate this condition. If this is false, then because this one is inside the if statement, it is a nested if, it will depend on this if. If this is false, it will not be executed. Now select this. None of these statements have been printed on the screen. Make this true and make this one false. Now only the first statement will be executed. Roshan. Now this if else statement in which the first if doesn't have any expression. So remove this expression. You only have to remove this expression and that's all. So now it will check both the conditions for this statement. If both of them are true, this will be printed, otherwise not. Select it, control enter, and it didn't give any output because this condition is true but this condition is false. If this condition is also true, A is not equal to B, then this portion will be printed on the screen. Yes, this is printed. The last if else statement are if else condition yes no. You can type directly these type of if else statements inside the console. So if first let's define A is equal to 5, B is equal to 6. If else the test is whether A is equal to B or not. And in the yes place, if this is true, then print out on the screen bring a Pepsi. And in case the condition is false, then bring a do. Let's run this. As this condition is false, A is not equal to B. That's why the second statement will be printed on the screen. Now let's make the statement true, not equal to B. Now if you press enter, the first statement will be printed on the screen because this condition has become true now. A is not equal to B. So that was all for today. Thank you for watching my videos. Bye.